posture and holding it correctly. Okay, so that's grip and not holding. So if I say pencil holding, this is pencil holding. If I say pencil handling, this is pencil handling. I can handle it the way I want. I can do it like this. But when it comes to grip, you have to know what is the correct grip of pencil. Well, today, since I had to do this workshop, I really had to prepare so many things, right? So I feel that even for a child to write, it is very important to make that child ready for that. And that ready, to make ready, is called readiness for writing. Okay, so today our workshop is for readiness to write or readiness for writing. Okay, anything you can quote. Now, for readiness to writing, we have to have pre-writing skills. These are all educational terms or a psychological terms which are called as pre-writing skills. Pre means always before writing. Before writing, what are you supposed to do? What are you supposed to practice so that whatever work you do is to your perfection? If not perfection, close to perfection. And also it counts the speed. So what are we going to do is, of course, when we think of writing, what things are involved in doing that? What things are involved in doing that? Your finger, your hand, and your mind. Of course, eyes, nose, all sense, but majorly, your fingers, your hand, and your mind. How do we prepare this for writing? We prepare this for writing by preparing our fingers, preparing our hand to hold the pencil and write. How do we get that readiness of hand? Readiness of hand, if I am not going very fast, please say thumbs up. If I am going very fast, give me thumbs down. I hope I am not very fast. Okay. Let me just check. The speed is okay? Okay. So, readiness for writing is all to do with your fine motors. FMS skills. And these are all your fine muscles. Fine motors are the motor muscles. Okay, there are three different types of muscles and nerves in our body, out of which we are talking about motor nerves and motor muscles. They are here. They are there present in all the joints of your finger. And so it's very important to strengthen those muscles through some aids or without aid. First, we are going to see how we are going to practice or strengthen our muscles without aid. How we are going to strengthen our muscles without aid. The first thing, please, teachers and parents, try to do this with me so that involvement of learning is actually learning. How do we do that? Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. See, without aid. You tie a fist and do boxing. Tie a fist, do boxing. Without aid, okay? Counting of finger. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Teachers, parents, y'all can make note just right so that you can remember. Now it is very easy for you to know, but later it is better to have a list of this. So when I'm doing this, once you do it, second time you write. You register this in your mind. This is counting fingers. See, when I'm counting, I'm actually pressing. See the strength I'm putting. And you also feel that this whole thing is getting stretched. If not, try to press it down so that this is all stretched. Then you try counting like this. 10, 10, 5, 10. I have have shown you how we are integrating our learning with our finger exercises. Okay, now, yeah, walk, 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 walk and tickle. You know, you remember we playing this game? I think like grandparents always played with us. I don't know whether these grandparents are playing or not, but this is what, 1, 2, 3, 4, walk, 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 and then you tickle, right? So fist, 1, 2, fist, 1, 2, 1, 2, walk, 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 walk. This is walking, finger exercise. Okay, now why only this 2 finger? Please relate it, because this is very important for us to hold pencil. So these 2 fingers, okay, walk. What other thing you can do is to scratch the table. Scratch the table, see, scratch the table. These are exercises without aids, without tools, without toys. Scratch the table. After scratching, you have to crawl it on the floor. When the child is sleeping, you just say, come on, crawl, 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 so it can crawl. Also, you can say, climb. Climb the wall. 2 fingers, huh? Only 2 fingers are involved in this particular exercise. Climb the wall. So crawl on the floor, climb the wall. Fingers cross fingers and press it, cross fingers and press it. Okay, these are few exercises. Best finger massage. So you have a rubber band, you just put a rubber band and tell the child to roll the rubber band here and there. Or make the child wear the ring and the child will roll it. That's finger massage. We make number tower, if you all know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Tell the child to make number tower. Actually, see the fist. Number tower. So when you're holding it, the child is actually holding it for some time. And that's why all these things were involved when we were learning numbers and all. These are intentionally involved in learning, so that you are preparing, the readiness for writing is happening unknowingly. Just because we are here to understand, these are few things that will help your child. So just tell your child to do like this, they will not enjoy much. Mama, it is boring. I don't want to do it. But if you count number and go with a space like 1, 2, so you know when you're saying 1, the child is actually holding it, holding the grip, holding the fist. 2, 3, 4, then you can do it faster for them to open, close, open, close, open, close. These are few finger exercises. Okay, now this is like holding the fingers and stretching. One second. Tani, come here. Yeah, hold the finger and stretch. Do you remember? I will just relate. Do you remember? Do you remember we playing this game? Do you remember during our childhood we played this game? See? So that game you can play with your child. That game you can play with your child. So you do this. And you play with your child like this. Okay? So this is all, these are all finger exercises without teaching, without any aid. I repeat, tying fist, twinkle, twinkle, little star, finger tie. Yeah, finger exercise, crawling, and climbing. Okay, cross fingers, finger massage, number tower. All these are finger exercises to strengthen your fine motors and for keeping your child or preparing your child for the grip. They are all without teaching aids. They are all without any tools, any aids, any toy. When I repeat this every time, I mean to say wherever you are, whether it is your bedtime, whether it is your breakfast time, whether it is your TV watching time, you all can do it. You need not prepare anything. And this is going to help your child for writing. Now, writing is not very, very easy. If you are not an artist, and if I give you a paint and say, come on, now you start and paint this for me, it's going to be a challenging for all of us. Why? Because it is not easy and we don't know, we are not prepared, we are not educated for doing this. Similarly, the feeling, the resonance is same like what the child feels when you give pencil and say, come on, now you write. Parents and teachers, please empathize with those children. They are yet very young to do this. And that's the reason why we don't allow any child to hold a pencil till 4. Till 4 years. When the child is 4 years old, that's the time when you gracefully get that pencil in front of the child. The child has urge to use that pencil. The child is excited to use that pencil, present it in a very good way at right time. It's like when your child is doing something good and when they achieve after 10th standard, you promise them to give a mobile and you say what are do's and don'ts. Similarly, this is a tool, this is a vehicle. Shastra hai, this is a tool, this is a weapon. And you are going to giving that weapon to that child. When you're giving weapon, talwar di jati thi, give with that honor, saying this is your weapon for education. Okay? So give that weapon with that honor and tell the child how to use this weapon. Merely giving and the child is about to shave everyone's head and cut everyone's head is not allowed. You have to prepare. Be Jija Mata there for Shivaji. And give that weapon saying that, come on now, we are going to practice how to use this weapon. How to use this tool. It is a tool. Respect this tool. So these were the exercises for readiness without any tool. There are few things which you all can practice even when the child is in the kitchen or they are with tools. They are with aids. For example, you see this atta? This is atta. This is atta. Right? So we have scheduled clay just to introduce because as a teacher, as a school curriculum, we cannot have it all the time or every day in the class. But if you all practice this every day with your child, this really helps. What you have to do is tell the child to roll it, tell the child to, you know, roll it long, make a snake out of it, make it messy for the child and tell the child to remove it. Just tell that, okay, before doing this, apply oil. Apply oil or Vaseline if you are not using this. Of course, you will not use it. Something sticky, oil, coconut oil, and tell your child to play with it. They will enjoy playing with clay or atta. Now, resourcing clay, buying clay, the clay gets dirty, children mix. It is very, very safe to use atta. Atta is best. Even if your child put it in your mouth, it is safe. But while showing this, teachers will definitely say not to put in mouth. You have to give some reminders. I am giving you atta, but please don't put it in your mouth. You can play, you can mess it. You know, let them spread it on the ground, on the floor and then scratch it and remove it. That is the fine, very good exercise for children to play with. So one with aid is atta. Second is sorting. Now, sorting will always have two things. Okay, what I have in this is soya chunks, soya bean, and what I have is marble in this. One is rough and one is smooth. See, there's a thought behind what I have mixed. You can have chickpeas, chana, chole, and you can have rajma. One is rough and one is smooth. Why this? Because everybody will not like this feeling. Everybody will not like this feeling. Secondly, for the tactile feel, you know, for making their fingertips sensitive, you tell them, give them two bowls and tell them, now it's time for you to sort out things for me. Okay, sorting is two things ready here. There are two bowls. I think it's not here. Yasha, hold it for some time. No? I will show it on the activity. Show it like this. Now it is clear, right? So I have some chickpeas here. I have this sorting. This will go in this, and this will go in this. The marble will go in this bowl, and the soya beads or soya chunks will go in this. So the child is picking up. Tell the child how to hold. Holding with all the fingers and sorting. Holding. See the grip. And this. This and this. That is sorting. Have you heard about squeezy ball? You all know squeezy ball. You all get squeezy ball, yellow color squeezy ball. You have to tell your child to just get squeezy ball two at a time, and the child can squeeze the ball. Or get one ball, the child can squeeze, get another ball, the child. What if I don't have squeezy ball? I can't go out because everything is locked. How do I do that? Because it's really a good exercise. What best you can do is, can you hold that? What best you can do is take a napkin. Okay? Tell your child to fold it. One fold, two fold. Take it upside. Basically, I'm trying to make a ball out of it. And then I squeeze it. This is what you can do with your child. Even not this, what best you can do is, you can have a pillow, cushion. Why we have a cushion fight? You take this and throw it. That's the game. So you have to press it once and throw it. You have to press it once. You all can be innovative. This is just to ignite the thought. You can innovate that. You can think over, put some thoughts and try to make it more interesting. So you squeeze the pillow cushion and then pass it. The child will squeeze it and pass it back so you catch it. So catching, throwing, again is fine motor and gross motor together. Okay, since we have cushion here, I will also say that you have to tell child to pinch the cushion. Pinch. Pinch is the word. They can't hold it like this. They can't catch it like this. You have to pinch the cushion. Pinch. Pinch is the word, and pinching is again exercise for index and thumb. You have to strengthen this muscle. You have to say, pinch the cushion. Holding. Keep it here. Yeah. Holding. Holding and handling is something that you need to know. Now keep it. I'm fine. Holding. Now, when you hold, let's see. See, when you tell child, hold it like this, make it interesting with your instruction, saying that, let's count how many fingers. What is the child doing? The child is exercising. Or aise karo, phir aise karo. Let's give massage to this bottle. Let us give massage to this bottle. If need be, put some water here and let the child do it with water. They will enjoy that. To go to make it more interesting, you can put some oil because they really become slippery, and then you can make the child say, massage the bottle. Later, you can also say, massage my leg, massage my hand. But yes, this is the grip they have to learn. Now, what, ma'am, if I don't have a bottle? Sometimes when you have this bottle gone, just press it. Press it and try to make a little softer for me so that I can cut it easily. Let the child press. The child is helping in kitchen. Mothers are stuck. Oh, what to do? Kya kaam do? Mera kaam mat bigado ye ne. Just tell, ye dekho, ye le lo. Press it so that it becomes little soft and I can easily cut it. The child will try his level or her level best to make your work easy. All for love. So they will do that. Slowly coming from bottle to bottle gourd, you will come to a stick. See, the grip is becoming smaller and smaller. The grip is becoming smaller and smaller gradually. So don't do all this exercise in one day. Try to make a chart out of it. 1 week you do this, other week. Now this grip has become smaller. So grip it. 5, 6. What is the length? 1 span, 2, 3, 4, 5 fists. So you can count. Or massage. 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 Okay? This is something that you can do. You all know threading the beads. Have good size of beads and thread the beads, which is very easy. You all can do that. Then you have newspaper. In PGs, in nursery, we give them this activity. Tearing. Just tearing. See the pinch. When you tear the paper, you feel the pinch, the pressure where all you are putting. When you tear the paper, you are putting pressure on your thumb and your index finger the most. Others are being only supportive. So tearing. Tearing newspaper is the best. And you have to tear this way. In nursery, you may tear it like this. Or PG. But when it comes to junior KG, what you have to do is tear, come back. Tear, come back. Tear, file it. Tear, file it. Tear. Now it is really difficult. But the child is putting pressure. And the resistance pressure will help to strengthen the muscle. So this is resistance pressure which the child is putting, but the effect is less. The result is not very well shown, but yes, they are putting pressure, and that pressure is more important than just merely tearing for junior KG. Taking it little head, folding. Folding of paper. Don't we do origami? Why do we do origami? So that it becomes creative and also for fine motors, readiness. So folding activity. Just tell your child, if you have read the paper, the child can come and help you, saying, beta, please fold this paper and keep. The child will come and fold the paper. Or tell the child to make folds and keep it for you to use it later. Give some instruction. Just don't tell them that fold this paper, it is for your school activity, and then only you will learn how to write. If you give all this instruction, the child knows that, oh, you are trying to teach me. If you ask for love and if you ask for help and support, they will be the first one to come and do everything beyond their limits. So you can talk, you can say that, please come and hold this for me. I need your help. They will do it. Don't make it a steady time. Don't make it a learning. Learning is happening, but don't quote it as learning and teaching. Okay. This is empty bottle, coconut bottle, coconut oil bottle. See, open, close, open, close. Now, if you tell the child will open it like this. You never know, the child will hold it like this and open. But when you're doing this as an activity, you have to actually instruct your child that thumb and index, two fingers, okay? One will be here, the other will be here, and open. So this is called the head, the back of the mouth, and this is the mouth. So open the mouth, close the mouth. Open, close. Empty oil bottle. There are no chance that the child will spill it and then you have to take care. So similar bottles can be used for strengthening the index and thumb. Cardboard. Okay. Peg it. Peg. Peg. Peg the board. If not board, peg the clock. Peg the clock. So peg, again, two, three fingers can be used and you can peg. Again, remove and keep it back. This is what you can ask. Fold the paper, fold the newspaper. And twist it. It shouldn't tear. Come on, twist, but should not tear. Twist the paper. Paper twisting. Twist the paper. Paper twisting. Similarly, cloth twisting. Again, fold the cloth and twist it. Parents, it's my humble request to please practice all this and know when you are doing it, where all you are applying pressure. So when I do this, I am applying pressure on my fingers, on my palm, and I can feel the pressure here also. So when you are writing, you will see that children are writing and they say, Mom, this is paining. My elbow is paining. Why? Because these muscles are not very strong. Fine motors are fine, but this muscles, the tendons here are not very fine. So similarly, you have to strengthen. All this twisting activity is specially to strengthen these tendons here. Twist. Okay? Paper twisting, cloth twisting, cloth folding. Fold the napkin and keep it on the dining table. Fold your t-shirt and keep it in your wardrobe. Fold the towel and keep it here. Fold the cushion, pillow cover, and keep it in the cupboard, wherever the child will help you. So that's folding. Okay, napkin folding, this folding. Now, this is something that, you know, there are grooves and these are marbles. Now, if your grip is not very sharp or not very good, there are chances that this will fall. You can also evaluate that smooth things will always fall if your grip is not very strong. So you have to give something very smooth for the child, for you to evaluate that, oh, if the grip is good or not. Just timely you give such activities and tell the child to put it in the groove. Put it in the groove here. Very simple. But if the grip is not there, that this will fall again and again. You have to know that it's time for you to work little more with your child by adding varieties and spices to these activities. Tearing and pasting is the activity that we usually do in PG, junior KG, senior KG. Pasting and tearing. Just tear, collage. Collage has been a hit for children. Cut pictures and tell the child to paste it. Cut, put Fevicol, use it and paste it. Just cut and paste on a paper and make something or don't make anything. Even if the child does pasting on a paper, it looks nice. So you can use newspaper and tell them to paste it on color paper, or you can use color paper and tell them to use it on newspaper. Whichever way is convenient to you all can do that. But yes, tearing and pasting, cutting and pasting. Your children are of this age, like 4 and all. You have a child friendly, you know, specially made scissors, plastic scissors for children. If you can resource that, we have it in our school, but if y'all can resource that, y'all can bring and tell your child to cut it with it. And they can cut and they can stick. 4 is really very young, but yes, if your child is like 4.5, 5, those plastic scissors will work wonder with them. Because when you are cutting, you put pressure with your fingers. And you have, coordination. How far, how hard you have to pull. So that coordination helps. Picking up beads. Just scattered beads, and you have to tell your child to pick up the bead. Picking up beads. Only 2 fingers. Picking up straws. Picking up toothpicks. Have variation. Picking up rajma seeds from the floor. Very difficult. Why? Because they are smooth. Floor is also very smooth. So it becomes difficult. But give that challenge to your child. They will achieve it. It's an evaluation for you to understand, but the child will do it as an activity. No problem. We will achieve. Maybe we will do it next time. No problem. Try. Let them pick up rajma from the floor. So pick up rajma seeds. Okay, these are all pre-writing skills with exercise, without aids, and with aids. So you do finger exercise and you do exercise with aids for fingers. Kavita, I request you to unmute all of them for another 5 minutes and then we will go to pencil grip. Thank you for bearing me so long and hearing me so long. Yes. Anyone who would like to say something before we go ahead? Is there anyone? Please raise your hand. Teacher, parent. Yes, Shubhan.
Ma'am.
Yes, Shubhan.
Ma'am, this exercise is for grip.
Yeah, this exercise is to make your fine motors strong. Everyone can practice. You know what? My grandmother used to practice this every day. When she was 55 years old, she used to practice all this every day. So this is meant for all the graders. All age can do this. It is fun giving, but yes, it strengthens your grip. Okay? Anyone here would like to ask something? No? Should we go ahead then? Yes. Not taking much time of yours? Anyone? Should we go for pencil grip for which we are waiting? Yes. Unless and until you all do. Okay, Kavita, unmute them. Mute them now. Yeah, we'll come back to your questions. Please make note of it. Whosoever was saying, I think that was Shubhan. Coming back to pencil grip. Now, why to have pencil grip? What is the intention? If it could have been a very interactive session, but since we are online, I don't give you all chance to speak much, but to take more. Okay, but I'm sure you all know, why do we need pencil grip? We need pencil grip to make writing stress free. we need pencil grip to make the child or let the child enjoy writing. We need a proper pencil grip for speed. We need a proper pencil grip so that the child can write for long. We need pencil grip for the endurance, for good handwriting, for precision. It is like you can read and good handwriting presentation always mine. But coming back to the fact that our children are computer age children, I don't think so they will write much during their time. But education is asking for writing. You have to write your question answer sheet. You have to attempt question examination. For that, writing is very important. So as a parent, your concern for your child to write is there because your child is going to appear for grade 10, because your child is going to appear for examination, because your child needs to complete their 12th standard and they have to write big, big answers and big, big formulas and big, big derivations. For that, fluency, the speed, the endurance, the handwriting, the format, everything matters. But as I told you, that you can only run the weapon when you know what are do's and don'ts, when you know how it is made, when you know why it is made, when you know that how it is to be used, then only you can achieve it to its fullest. Coming back to types of pencils. Okay. When, if I say during our times, I won't be wrong because I also belong to same this. During our times, we had pencils which were, I have all this tripod, which were only circular. They were round pencils. Okay. And you will see that this generation, our generation, you will have people with different types of grip. Some are writing like this. Some are holding pencils and like this. And they are writing. But nowadays, because education and because psychology has become the most important subject for us to survive in any field, people have thought about pencils and they have designed a pencil. And those design pencils are called as tripod pencils. Why they need to design a tripod pencil? Why? Why? Because the studies, the research says that when you hold pencil, when the pencil grip is correct, then only the usage and the handwriting will be good. Then coming back to what is a pencil grip? For pencil grip, for children to prepare pencil grip, you have to play shadow game. When I say shadow, you have to actually show, oh, take a, what is this? This is a butterfly. Okay, what is this? This is a bird. What is this? This is a peacock. Shadow. Do it a shadow play. Then, what is this? This is deer. And what is this? Elephant. And what is this? Crocodile's mouth. This is crocodile mouth. And what is this? Pinch. 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 So this is crocodile's mouth. You can also use alligator because it's small. Crocodile really have long, but you say alligator, or you can say deer, or you can say dog, but say mouth. Okay? And this is a pinch. For pencil grip, this grip is very important. So tell your child to hold two fingers, index and tall man, and your thumb and press it. Pinch it hard. Pinch. Again, you pinch the cloth. You peg it with your fingers. Pinch. So this is the exercise. Slowly in this, you try to insert your pencil. Now, what is very important is the pencil should be held in 1, 2, and 3. Pinch grip for support is what you know because you are teaching them. So you know that this is. Now you can't expect the child to understand index finger should be here, the pointer should be here, the tall man should be here. Don't expect that. The right vocabulary for you to use with this 4 graders is the alligator's mouth, deer's mouth, crocodile's mouth, or a pinch grip. So first thing is the child should be well prepared for pinch grip. You have to tell child, make a pinch grip and press my finger, press my hand. You will know when the child is pressing hand what pressure they are putting. And slowly insert, okay, now take this in your pinch. The pinch grip, these fingers are not involved in writing. This is for support and this is how you hold. Now, when I say the pencil should not be standing, it shouldn't be perpendicular to your hand. Now these terms, perpendicular and this, you can't give. But as an adult, I am using for you to correct. The pencil angle should be 45 degree with the notebook. When I say 45 degree, am I going to take a protector and a scale and measure it to 45 degree and then check? No. The best thing is the pencil should rest on this. The pencil should rest on this is 45 degree. Easiest way for us to know that what is 45 degree. The pencil should rest on this. Two things you have to remember. Two things that you have to remember is pinch grip and 45 degree. So when your child is writing the pencil is like this, what you have to do is the best is to rest it here. When the child will again write like this, this is more smoother and convenient for them. This is little difficult, but you can't say, no, that is wrong, that is wrong. Eventually, gradually, you know, just shift the pencil top here and say, yes, right. Keep writing, but you shift it here. You don't say that it is not 45 degree and this is 60 degree and don't confuse your child. Again and again, I'm repeating, these instructions are meant only for parents, not for your children. This is called 45 degree. If you all have pencil or pen next to you all, please try this grip. These fingers are just supporting. This is a grip. The tall man slowly or automatically comes for support here when you try to give 45 degrees. This is the correct pencil grip. Children should practice this. You all should intentionally see that there is a pinch grip and okay. The child may hold the pencil here. The child may hold pencil here and write and still write. You can write a good handwriting. See, when it comes to calligraphy, the one who is doing it will do it like this. They will hold it here, they will hold it here, they will hold it here, because that's the requirement of the formation of letters and formation of pictures and formation of art. But when we are holding it, the letters and numbers that we are going to write, the formation will be better this way. If you want good handwriting, please tell your children to hold it from the neck. This is the mouth, this is the back, and this is the neck of the pencil. So we are also going to use the term neck of the pencil. The child should pinch at the neck of the pencil and the pencil should rest between the pointer and thumb So whether it is resting here or whether it is resting here, when they come to senior KG, we tell them again and they consciously keep it here. Ma'am, see, my pencil is here. Ma'am, see, I have kept it. So we give a reminder saying that, okay, someone's pencil is standing tall. You need to slide it little down, and they realize, oh, we have to keep it here. So they do it. If you all also do it, then they will learn this writing faster, and same instructions can flow for them to grasp it faster and learn the pencil grip faster. So this is pencil grip. Pinch at the neck of the pencil, and pencil should rest between the thumb and the pointer. Give the child paper to write. Always tell them to write big first. Coming back to writing big. In our school, we have crayons which is ball-shaped crayon, where PG and nursery children hold the ball and then they color. It is more convenient and easier for them to color like this. Why? Because their fine motors are not well developed to hold a pencil, a thin pencil like this, or a thin crayon like this. We also have a thick crayon. So going from ball to a thick crayon, which is almost like size of three chalk, we have that big crayon. They hold that crayons and then they color the newspaper. Then we come to junior KG, where they have this crayon. And in great senior KG, we have those thin crayons, plastic crayons. They are thinner than this. Because in senior KG, we encourage children to use pencils. We encourage children to write in RBBR. So there is a limited space where they are expected to write. So we tell them to use pencils. In junior KG, these crayons. If your child is writing with pencil, you can say, come on, it's okay if you're not writing with pencil. Give them thick crayons to write, and that's okay. Make your paper colorful by writing colorful M in all the grid that has been given to you, or all the imaginary lines that you get. Let your child write with crayons. Don't force your child. Don't force your child to write with pencil if your child is not ready. Whether your child is in grade 1 or whether your child is in senior KG, if your child is not ready to write with pencil, please, please don't force your child to write with pencil. But to achieve this, please practice pre-writing skills, give them thick crayons, let them write with thick crayons, and make writing interesting. That's why pre-writing also includes coloring. Coloring is majorly designed for child to take it for writing on paper and writing on paper with pencil or pen. So coloring is very, very important. If your child is not writing, it's okay. Tell your child to color. Let the child color. First, give your child paper where they can color. Then give them limited space that you have to color. So junior KG is practicing copywriting cards, right? They are doing copy cards. Why those copy cards? Why? Because we have given them a limited space. Those are all pre-writing. We have given them limited space to color so that they keep that. They have to only color that space and they should not go beyond. That's to keep control over their pencil, to keep control over their crayons, and also to coordinate the mind with their hand. So they are coloring only to that limited space. Why aren't we giving them pencils to color that? Because it is not meant for their age. Okay, so they can write with crayons to begin with. If you feel that crayons are really working, change the size of crayon, come to a thinner crayon. You think that they can write with thinner crayons, then you tell them, introduce to their weapons. this tool. This is a tool. Okay? So give them this tool and then tell them, now you write. Parents, only use tripod pencils. Only use tripod pencils. Okay? You know that there are different things coming up with different challenges. So, since people around or the marketing people knew that children are facing with writing, they have come with pencil grip. They have grippers, pencil grippers. As an experienced teacher, I would advise, please avoid using that. Why? Because once they are used to, see, you have to try. If there is no solution, then what is best you can give? But try avoiding. Given an option, given a choice, we will always try to be, okay, I only want this. You don't try to adjust. If you have choice, adjustment becomes very difficult. But if you give them no choice, then you can tell them, this is how it is. Pencil grippers are not good for you. But if you know that that's the only solution, then please get them a gripper. Otherwise, don't introduce them to a gripper. Okay. Pencil grip can be only introduced when teacher asks you to do that. It is a medicine. Gripper is a solution to a problem. Not because you like it, you take it. No. Just because the syrup, the cough syrup tastes good and you drink it because it is tasting good. No, don't do that. Similarly, don't get a gripper unless and until teacher or any expert tells you to get it. Now, even if you want to use gripper at home, you have a pen where this plastic thing, the rubber thing, you can take out that and use it in the pencil. But if you are using circular pencils, then grippers will work. If you're using tripod pencils, they are specially designed for that grip. They are designed for that grip where you can put 1, 2, and 3 fingers. See? This is a tripod pencil. Mapet, Fibercastle, in fact, Flora, all are coming up with tripod pencils. Please use tripod pencils. Avoid using pencil gripper and tell your child, first practice with this, let them write with crayons, then we come to pencil. It is a beautiful transformation you see when your child is coming from crayons to pencil. Enjoy that childhood, enjoy that learning with your child. Make it interesting, give them their own time to explore their way of writing. We just keep a check on our children that they don't write like this, because that causes problem on their ankles, on their wrist. It will cause problem here, and also they won't be able to write much. And writing will be a problem for them. They will say, I don't want to write. If you want, I will read, but I will not write. Why? Because they are unable to express to you that this is the pain. I am unable to do it. It is a challenge. Every day for me to overgo this challenge is difficult, Mama. I can't do it. Empathize. Talk to your child. Why you don't want to write? Make it interesting for them. Writing is very, very enjoyable activity. Children will enjoy. Show them that this is your... Get beautiful pencils for them. Colorful pencils for them. With flowers, with cartoons. Create interest around that pencil. Talk about pencil. Talk about some cartoons around that. See, whenever we go for a birthday or this, they give us those pencils with head on that. You talk to your pencil. There's some little puppet head on that. Create something. Talk with that puppet. Talk with your pencil. And then let pencil come and flow on the paper. Just writing with pencil will become very difficult for you.
Padma teacher, your video and audio is hung. Can you hear us? Yeah, your video was hung. Yes, now it's fine. Now it's fine.
Are you talking to me, Kavita?
Yes, your video had stopped for a few seconds and we couldn't hear you at all. Okay. So, yeah, now we can hear.
Okay. So, I repeat that it is a beautiful journey. Writing is beautiful journey for a parent, for a child. Make it as interesting as you can. Use beautiful pencils. Let it have a head on it or some cartoon character which your child likes. Talk to them. Tell the child now that this your friend of yours would like to come. Create a story around it and make writing very, very interesting and good. Because, yes, unless and until you express in words, you don't get marks. This is the fact of education. Fact. Underline fact. The baseline is your child will get marks. Though education system is working hard, only writing is not the evaluation, should not be the parameter of evaluation. But let's go with the flow. If considering this time, writing and getting is a major portion of writing. Please follow do's and don'ts. Don't give all simple, give only simple instruction. Don't give all this psychological and scientific and logical reason for why the child should hold pencil like this. Ye tumhare isko kaam karega, isko idhar pressure aa raha hai kya nahi, udhar pressure aa raha hai kya nahi. Don't do this. That. Okay, Kavita, please unmute all of them. Yes, I am ready to take. Who would like to speak one by one? Raise your hand and let.
If anybody has any questions, you can just raise your hand so we can open up your mic. Anyone who has questions, you can raise your hand and we'll open up your mic. Yes, Ved's mom, you can go first.
First of all, thank you so much, ma'am, for taking out time for this. And this was a very short thing which you had to prepare for us, and it was very beautifully explained. And thank you, really thank you so much. Never knew why PG and nursery, you know, make the children do messy things. I think now we come to know that. And okay, and one thing that, like, the middle finger or the long finger, as we say, to rest over here, you know, like when we hold the pencil. So to rest the pencil, how can we, you know, like guide them? Because holding this is easy, but resting the middle finger over here, this.
I think Padma teacher went off. She'll join back. Now, as per the technique, okay, I will show you exactly how I'm holding the pencil.
Okay.
I'm not using this finger here at all. Okay.
Okay.
Because I will have the paper here. And I need to rest the pencil on the paper. So if the pencil is correctly resting on this point here, mm-hmm. in this portion, if it's resting here, just this pinch grip is actually sufficient, you know. But if children still need it, they can just keep it slightly open. But eventually what happens is, mm-hmm. this portion starts to feel too much
pressure,
and it starts to get hurting here. Okay, so that means any part of your grip. Padma teacher, you went off, so I took over.
No, take it.
So if it is actually resting fine over here, okay, and it doesn't need any other grip, you see, it is not requiring any other grip, it doesn't really need the grip of this middle finger over here. Okay, it is resting well here. I personally write like this. Okay. I always just write like this. I really don't even need the support of this finger or any other fingers. Okay. I write like this. I remember when in school I used to write, I used to take support of this finger and the pencil would rest here like this. Okay. So when you're writing, you're soft on the paper, but the entire pressure is coming on this finger here. And I used to keep having this portion all sore. यहाँ पे गड्ढा जैसे हो जाता था एंड दिस होल पोर्शन यूज टू गेट सोर एकदम लाल होके इट यूज टू पेन यू नो आफ्टर 4-5 पेजेस इज डिफिकल्ट टू कंटिन्यू एंड वी यूज टू हैव दोस चिजल्ड पेंसिल्स ऐसे शायद वो हेक्सागोनल पेंसिल्स होते थे तो उनका एक एक पॉइंट आप कितना भी यू नो थोड़ी देर के बाद उसको ऐसे ऐसे घुमाते जाओ वो यहाँ पे दर्द होते रहता था माय मॉम करेक्टेड मी सेइंग दैट यू आर पुटिंग प्रेशर एट द रॉन्ग प्लेस पेपर पे प्रेशर डालो उंगली पे क्यों प्रेशर डाल रहे हो पेपर इज सपोज टू टेक इम्प्रेशन ऑफ व्हाट यू आर राइटिंग सो आई ग्रेजुअली लर्नड टू डू अवे विद दिस पेंसिल दिस फिंगर सो आई इवन टुडे जस्ट राइट लाइक दिस ओके So it gives a lot of flexibility. Now, whenever I want, I can rest on this. But otherwise, I can just hold like this and keep writing for long hours. It doesn't really hurt. Huh? Some point of time, your fingers are going to hurt. It's like, you know, aadhe ghante ke workout ke jagah mein 4 ghanta workout karenge, toh your muscles are going to hurt. So, wo toh dard hoga hi. Bilkul writing mein dard nahi hota, aisa kuch nahi hai. Dard hoga because... You are putting a lot of effort, you know, especially on the days of exams, jahan 3-3 ghanta ek saath baith ke likhna hai. You will keep on stretching like that, oof, because you are realizing that the whole hand is working. So, on those days, those are exceptional days. But udhar tak hum pahunchne ke liye correct technique rahega, to our work will not be on all of this because all these have worked out on all these years. It will only work from here and you'll just keep writing. But for that, these first few years, these building years make it very important. So actually, if you're having the right grip, this finger doesn't come into work at all. Padma teacher, I'll pass it to you now.
Coming back to question, what was the question?
She was asking, how do you rest the pencil on this finger? Because if you're going to hold it like this, What is the way to rest it on? Ved, Mama, you go ahead. You ask your question. I'll not repeat.
Ma'am, the question is that like when I ask Ved to hold a crayon, so he just closes his all the fingers and he hold it with just two fingers. So the pencil tend to be perpendicular and, you know, it tends to move and it comes out of the grip, like it slips off. So how do I tell him that, you know, you need to keep the middle finger little for the support? So he gets irritated. So maybe definitely I'm going to do these exercises with him. But again,
so what Kavita explained just now was correct, very correct. Actually, what is working is only these two fingers and this. Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you hold your crayons like this and you, we don't encourage children to write with smaller pencil. Please don't. Please don't. If it comes to this size and they are smaller than this and it is poking here, change the pencil. Okay. Always give children sufficiently tall and long pencils so that they can write. What is important is this two grip and this pinch grip is important for writing. And resting your pencil here is important. This is merely for support. If the child is not taking, you are blessed. But if just holding it like this and writing and making it conscious, when the fist is like this, it is more convenient. Holding your finger like this and then writing, this become very stressful. But if the child is holding and doing it like this, good. But 45 degree is very important. That is to rest the pencil here. Is very, very important. Take care of this. And it shouldn't be perpendicular. Once it is perpendicular and the grip is, then it is going to fall. Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Anyone next would like to ask?
Any questions? Vaishnavi ki mummy, any questions that you have? No? Okay, fine. Shayona, Eva, Myra's mom, any question that you have? Myra's mom, you had certain concerns yesterday. Any questions that you have today? Okay, I don't think her video is on. Avantika's parents, any questions that you have? No. Then I think we are good. I think if there's anything, they can always come back and ask later.
Yeah.
So I think as of now, we are good. Okay, Eva's mom has written here, no questions, I'm good. Okay, fine. Theek hai. Okay.
So we are done. With pre-writing skills and pencil grip. Thank you, parents. Thank you, teachers. Any more questions if you have, anything if you think over, you know, today morning we have learned, but it is there in our mind and if something can pop up, please feel free to write in your WhatsApp group. We will try to answer this. Enjoy writing. Enjoy teaching. Enjoy your weekend. Do take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.